Yo guys, what's going on? It's your boy KEEPLAYING. Welcome back to a new video. As you can see, I have myself a PlayStation 5 disc edition right here, right now in 2020, which is quite crazy because you can't get this anywhere. And I didn't even pre-order this. So think about that. I also do have myself another extra controller. I also did buy a Miles Morales Spider-Man game for the PlayStation 5 pre-ordered edition. I will also get myself Call of Duty Black Ops, which I could make some videos if I have time. I'm still in the army, obviously. I came back yesterday from the army for the weekend, so that's quite exciting as well. I'll make another video about that later, so check out, make sure to subscribe to my channel, hit the bell icon so you know when I upload my video. Anyways, there's nothing to wait about. Let's go open this up and show you how awesome this thing is. What's going on? Let's start. So we're gonna start off with the PlayStation 5 first, and then we'll move on to the controller that they give as its own. Obviously, as you guys can see from the box on its own, this is a certified Singapore-only version. So basically what this difference is the cable that they give you, the power cable, is specifically only gonna work for Singaporean sockets and like adapters. If you're using the US version, you would obviously need the US version of the adapter, but that's not gonna apply to us because we have that specific cable. So this is the front of the box. If you want to look at this, you can just probably pause the video and just take a look at that. And I will show you the side, which is over here right now. Pretty awesome as well. It has the PlayStation 5 on its side, on its top, as well as the PlayStation 5 controller right below it, and just normal branding, Sony PlayStation 5 basic shenanigans. And if we turn around the box, you can immediately see that they have quite a lot of information back here. The same thing, really, nothing much in different languages, pretty much, just to get you a hold of what the basic idea. And to the top right, we have the storage, 825 gigabytes. Now, there's been a lot of controversy about this, given that this is the stated storage, but actually you only have 600 something you've used because of the operating software. I'll get more of that onto a later video, or maybe just later on in this video. Anyways, I'm going to show you guys the last part of this side, the box, which is just what this says, PS5, Sony. Pretty straightforward, nothing really out of the ordinary. It's pretty much the same thing. Yeah, I think now it's perfect timing and a good segue to check out what's actually inside the box. So here we are, opening it up. All right, it's the moment of truth, guys. So obviously, as you can see, this is unsealed. And the reason they do that is, I'm not actually exactly sure why they do this, but it's unsealed the way I got it. But that's perfectly fine because I was able to check what's inside and whatnot, the basic shenanigans, you guys know. Anyways, obviously the first thing you do right here is they show you how to take out the box and how to open and unbox this thing to ensure that there's no damage that occurs when you do so. And they do tell you how to transfer your stuff from the PlayStation 4 to the PlayStation 5, which I will do after unboxing this because I do have a few games and storage stuff that in the PlayStation 4 that I would want to transfer over to my PS5, which I will show you guys how to do in a few minutes time. Anyway, so here we are. We have the handle over here. If we just lift it up, it opens up very, very smoothly. And we can take these two flaps outside. And in the corner, we have this opening junction, which you could just pull up. And here you have, boy, that looks awesome. So as you can see, this is the cable that you'll receive. Quite similar to the one in the PlayStation 4. Unlike the Xbox Series X, the PlayStation 5 and PlayStation 4 have internal power supplies, which is quite awesome, actually. They've been implementing this since a long time ago. And this is pretty straightforward, just plug and play. Very, very easy. This cable, obviously, right here, is the same cable as they use for the PlayStation 4. It's pretty cool, nothing different. No more, no less. So I'll just put that to the side. Over here, we do have the instruction manual, which honestly, no one's gonna read. But if you really are confused, if you have something to look at, you can obviously open this up and you have exactly what you need to start your experience. They have one in Chinese Mandarin and one in English. And yeah, that's pretty much it. Over here is the main deal. This is why people buy the PlayStation 5. Oh my goodness, that's a bit heavy, actually. It's very, very awesome. If I open this up, you'll see the controller. Oh my goodness, that's awesome. That is awesome, guys. Right off the bat, I can tell the difference from the PlayStation 4 controller, which I have. You can see the difference between this and this. The main difference is that, well, this is much bigger. Obviously, there's a huge design change, but the main change you can see is the touchpad, which is obviously a bit different. And the power button over here is much bigger and it's around, whereas in the PlayStation 5 controller, it's just the logo, which is pretty cool. Just press it, it works. It's pretty awesome. Oh, I just mistakenly turned it on. Anyway, on the back side, we have this pretty much straightforward terms and conditions, just informing you guys of here. And you have the headphones and stuff like that. One of the best things about the PlayStation 5 controller is that it's USB-C, which obviously most people nowadays need, because USB-C is what we use nowadays in the modern tech era of 2020 ETC. It just feels so much better in the hand. It's just more ergonomically designed. I feel like this is one of the main reasons why the PlayStation 5 is much more higher in demand than any other console in the moment. So this is one of the top selling points of the PS5. And this is the stand, very, very important stand. Now, the reason I say this is because a lot of people tend to not follow this instruction. I've seen a lot of reviews online, people not following the recommended usage of this. You can actually damage your PlayStation console if you don't use the stand. Because of the airflow, the instructed, engineered cooling system of the PlayStation 5 ensures the need of this stand. So if you use this, you will have a much better life, and you will not hear any loud noises when you're using the PlayStation. So this stand is going to be one of the most important things of your PlayStation 5 experience. So make sure you're going to use it. Obviously, I don't have much space. Currently, my PlayStation 4 is sitting down here. I will need to replace this PlayStation 4 and make my PlayStation 5 stand here. Standing tall, obviously, I can't make it lie sideways because I don't have space. Plus, I think it just looks much better by making it stand up. So you guys should probably try that as well. You also have an HDMI 2.1. Now, obviously, if you're going to buy a PlayStation 5, you need to get a good display. If you're not going to get a display that's at least 4K, there's no point in buying the PS5. Just don't do it, because you're wasting money on buying a PlayStation 5 and not being able to experience what is the most out of it, which is the display. Now, I have over here a LG CX OLED display. This is the AI ThinQ version, 55-inch. I recently bought this, and it hasn't even been a month yet. And this is perfect for the PlayStation 5 because it's actually 120Hz, it's G-Sync, although the PlayStation 5 is an AMD processor and an AMD GPU, it doesn't matter. Regardless, this can handle all the gaming you want to push into it. It's just fantastic. It's been awesome for my PS4. Even with the upscaling it has, I think for the PS5, it's going to be perfect. And obviously, if you don't have a good TV like this, you can find one on sale for Black Friday or Cyber Monday. Any 4K TV will do, to be honest. I will have a few recommended affiliate links in the description below, so you can go and buy yourself a new TV. Pretty much easy like that. Here we have the HDMI cable. Obviously, it's a bit blocky, but I think that's just a design to ensure that the HDMI 2.1 is powerful in its usage. Obviously, it would be a bit more better if it was a bit streamlined and a bit smaller, but hey, I'm not complaining. They're giving you an HDMI, and it's ready to go, 2.1, 4K, 120Hz. Here we are. Box, honestly, the box itself is kind of heavy. I also did forget this one more important thing, which you don't want to do, is actually the charger for the PlayStation 4, a PlayStation 5 controller. Which is also USB-C, like I mentioned. It's pretty much standardized nowadays. And that's pretty much it. There's nothing else in this box. And the only thing left is the PS5 on its own, which I think they recommended us to do like this. So I will do that. I'll probably get this out of the way, as a matter of fact, just to make this a bit more of a clean experience. I have been told by a lot of people that this will be a big console. Now, I feel like that's a bit of an exaggerated fact, but after looking at this right now, I feel like that is a fair enough judgment, because this thing is huge compared to the Xbox Series X, and as a matter of fact, just compared to my PlayStation 4, it is exactly what huge means. It's incredibly big, and I think Sony designed this purposely just to make it stand out. So if you have guests coming over at your home and they just see this huge ass thing in your house, they'll be like, damn, that's big, that's awesome. Yeah, that's a PlayStation 5. Here it is, ladies and gentlemen. Oh my goodness, that, you know, that is a beauty. Well, obviously, there's some dust particles out here. This here is a fingerprint magnet, so be careful when you're touching it. You might have to clean it quite often if you're really into that aesthetics of this whole thing. But to be honest, I feel like it's not much of an issue regarding the fact that it's just going to be standing there. It's not open to dust. It's in an open space. If you're putting it in an open space, it's not that big of an issue. So yeah, so I, you know what I think? I think this is pretty cool. Obviously, I think we're gonna have to put the stand and just turn it on. But before we do that, I would like to show you guys a closer look at what's on the side. Now this, obviously, the bottom of the PlayStation 5 is one of the cooling intakes, is where the stand goes here, and it actually gives a better airflow for all the cooling to come out. And on the back side, we have this. Obviously, this is the power in for the PlayStation 5. This is the HDMI point, HDMI 2.1, LAN cable, and two USB 3.0 sections. Now, I think these are USB 3.2. I'm not exactly sure, but if it is, then I'm guessing it's not much of an advantage, because most of the consoles nowadays do have this configuration, and it is much of an advantage, I would say. Now in the front we have one USB-C, preferably for your controller. If you are using a USB-C to USB-C, much faster download speeds, as well as charging speeds, if that's what I wanted to say. And as well as a USB here, which I'll probably use to connect my charger. Now, what down here is the power button and the eject button. Obviously, this drive is right here, the 4K Blu-ray UHD disk drive we have, which is pretty awesome. You know what? I think that's pretty much it for this unboxing experience. If I was to crouch down right next to it and take a look at how big this thing is, this is how big it is. It's insane. It's actually huge. And I actually kind of like this thing. Most people might disagree with this fact, but I feel like this is one of the biggest selling points of the whole PlayStation 5. It's unanimous design, its magnificent look, and just how the PlayStation 5 controller works with this beauty. That's exactly why people buy this, and it's high demand. You can't find it anywhere today. Anyway, we're gonna turn this baby on and show you guys how it works. I'm gonna turn on the PlayStation 5 for the first time, and I want you guys to be here to witness this beautiful moment.
Huh?
Oh my god, look at how cool that is. Dude, that's just insane.
Yo.
Aloy, hey, you guys can see me in the reflection over here. Wait, I need to turn on. Wait, increase the sound. Bro, that's mad. That's mad. Okay, I have to connect the PS5 controller to my PS5. Ola, can you hold this for me?
Oh, sure.
All right, so here I am. Make sure don't shake too much. Okay, so guys, we need to connect this cable to the PS5, which I'll open up right now.
Connect your controller to the console with the USB cable and press the PS button.
Okay.
Connect your controller to
the console with the USB cable and press the PS button.
So here I have USB-C cable, USB-C right here.
Connect your controller to the console with the USB cable and press the PS button.
I'm gonna press PS button. Here we have the controller.
Select
your language. English, United Kingdom. English, United States.
Yeah, I don't think I speak Spanish.
Yes, yeah.
So I think I'm just going to stick with American English.
Continue with the screen reader turned on.
Turn off. I can read. All right, so the circle should be filled without showing any black borders. Yep.
Well,
that's pretty much it. Adjust HDR. Let's adjust the HDR, make it brighter. Barely visible. Okay, that's barely visible. Now you guys can't see this properly because this is an HDR, which obviously you have to be in person to see. It's quite hard to capture on the phone or a camera, etc. This is an in-person experience, which I don't expect anyone to be able to see through a TV. Okay, so that's pretty much good. Continue. Yeah, let's install the PlayStation 5. Miles Morales. Here I am, Spider-Man Miles Morales. I pre-ordered this game about a month ago. The reason I did that is because pre-ordering the game gives me a few bonus skins, as well as a few additional stuff that I will show you in the game. So here we have, the box is pretty much clean. Every other PS5 game comes with this white border, which I think looks fantastic. It aligns with the new design of the PlayStation 5. It's brand new, I haven't even opened it. I went and collected this today, along with my PlayStation 5. Like I mentioned, I actually just came from the army camp yesterday. I came, I think at 12 p.m. or something. I came back home, I relaxed, I had some good food finally, because the food in the camp is honestly not something to commend. But my experiences in the army are going pretty well. I'll make an update video about that pretty soon. You guys can join me. We have to go install this inside
PS5.
So let's go. We have the disc in my hands right here, right now. We're gonna put this inside the PS5 for the first time. I actually don't know which way.
It's probably that way. Oh!
I noticed something. Okay, it's recognizing some discs, so that looks pretty good so far. Let's see what they are talking about. I think I might have inserted the disc the wrong way. Oh wait, they explained clearly how I'm supposed to insert it. So yep, I definitely did it the wrong way. Let's do it again, properly this time. So I'm guessing the cover of the disc has to be facing to the inward side, the top side. And now I think in a few seconds we'll recognize the disc. Here we are. So power options for rest mode. Optimized experience, low power use, custom. Now, to be honest, unless you're like on a really, really poor power saving consumption scheme, it doesn't really matter. I'm gonna use optimized experience because that will not only optimize the battery of the PlayStation 5 DualSense, but pretty much easy for me to just turn on and start playing out of nowhere. So I'll use this, okay? And obviously the software license agreement, which I think you should read as a future lawyer, I'm telling you this, but I'm not going to because I'm too lazy right now. Alright, update the software. Okay, so we actually just recently got a software update, the first very software update from Sony. We got one today. As a matter of fact, I don't think I've connected... Oh yeah, my dad connected a LAN cable, so we don't have to do much into that right now. Restarting my PS5. Yo, this experience, I have to say, is one of a kind. The first time I'm booting up my PlayStation 5, looking at the controller... Look at how cool that is. Look at that. And the triggers, Mom, you have to experience this later. It's very, very cool. It's like whenever you do something, right? It's resistive triggers coming here. So like if you shoot a gun, you can feel the gun shooting. If you're like walking on ice, you can feel the ice. Walking on sand, you can feel the sand. It's really
cool.
Look at
the speed!
Honestly, I don't even believe this kind of speed. It's just insane. But obviously that's because our internet speed is pretty fast.
Yeah, also.
But the download speeds in this PlayStation 5 is incredible. 5.5 gigabytes per second. The read and write speed is incredible. It's about 15 or even more times better than
no
the PlayStation
signal.
4. Now, obviously, the reason we're getting no signal is because we just restarted the PlayStation 5. It's installing the software update. But look at that blue tint coming out from the side of the PS5. That looks cool. You can see that?
I'm focusing on it.
A lot of you might miss or might want to see.
Some YouTubers might skip.
All right, so I'm going to sign in. Obviously, I have a PlayStation app installed on my phone. I've done this last week. So I'm pretty much prepared for that. The new stuff. So sign in on PS5, enable camera access, allow, and I can scan my code if I go a bit closer. Here we are, all set, I'm done, that's pretty much it. I'm already logged into my PS5. See, that's how fast that was, insanely fast. Adrian Munner, I have a Batman face on there. As you guys know, I'm a huge Batman fan, that's probably why. Also, if you're a PlayStation Plus member, you get, I think, 15 games for free on a PlayStation Plus, so you're pretty cool. Adjust privacy settings. I'm pretty open. Everyone knows who I am, so I don't really care. You know what, guys? I'll quickly come back to you after I do this, because it's going to be a bit of a... I think my battery for this is also finished, so I'm going to have to do some stuff, so I'll get back to you for that. Yeah. I'm going to go a bit of a handheld mode here, just me. Basically, what just happened was I forgot to show you guys. All I did was I connected my PlayStation 4, turned it on. I didn't even switch to my PS4. All you had to do was turn on your PS4 and just click on search for PS4s in the same network. I'm using a LAN cable, so it's the same LAN. You just have to click on search and it will just search for your PS4 immediately. All you had to do was turn on and press your on button once, your power button once, and it would just beep once and this PS5 would have known already. So the data I'm going to transfer is both of these accounts that I have on my PS4. I'm just going to click on next, and I should be able to sync my trophies and stuff like that, save data, everything. Okay, so the games I want to transfer for now will just be this, Spider-Man, maybe, I don't know. I'm probably just going to download, actually, what? None of these. I'll download them personally later on. I'll transfer this for now. I'll download Miles Morales, which is already installed inside. Installing so far. So that's pretty cool. Yeah, I'll get back to you guys once the PS5 is all started up and ready to go. So guys, here we are. I'm downloading Astro's Playroom. I think that's what it's called. Basically, this is what you want to do as soon as you get your PlayStation 5. It basically displays everything that this baby can do right here. Everything that this is capable of, this demo shows it. And I think there's no way of explaining its experience. You have to feel it for yourself. It's really hard to describe. It's one of those things where you have to be there in person to feel.
Yo, that's so cool. Look.
It's hard. Can you guys see this?
Yep.
Let me turn off the sound on my TV just to show you guys the sound that the PlayStation 5, the DualSense makes. Abba, I think you should feel this. Just try.
Oh. That's weird. It feels like you're actually landing.
And that, ladies and gentlemen, is Astro's Playroom. Now, obviously, the game is a bit more lengthy and has a lot more stuff, but it's just for demo purposes that they have included this game. Personally, I believe that this is something that we should consider having with us. We should play this game. But before all that, I believe we should play Spider-Man Miles Morales first. For that, you're gonna have to join us in another video. For now, I think we're gonna have to continue into the last section of this video, which is unboxing the PlayStation extra controller that they give us. You've probably seen this before already, but here we are. I have an extra one just for us to open and find out what's inside. So let's do that. Here we are. I have the PlayStation 5 controller right here. Now, obviously, I have the actual DualSense they give me with the PS5, but I have an extra one here that I bought for me and my brother to play together if we do it at some point. We can both have one controller. Or as well as common sense, if one goes out of battery, I have another one to use.
Yeah.
So pretty much the box is pretty cool, actually. It says heighten your senses, say the same thing in Chinese and Japanese. I think that's Korean. That's Korean, my bad. So that's the controller again, haptic feedback, adaptive triggers, built-in microphone, signature comfort, etc. This is a Singapore product, so we have the fact that this is purchased in Singapore. For any warranty / issues that we face, we can always go back and replace this with the actual product. Now, obviously, this is $100, but I think it retails at a different value for the USD. I'm not exactly sure on its US value, but for me in Singapore, it's $100, but it should be roughly around 70 something in USD. I'm not exactly sure,
but the controller itself is actually kind of heavy.
Yeah, the controller itself is kind of heavy compared to the PlayStation 4 controller. This is a very, very light thing, but the weight is justified by the amount of engineering inside this DualSense controller, the amount of haptic feedback stuff. They have the motors, they have each motor depending on the side. If you open up and watch the teardown of the PlayStation 5 controller DualSense, you would see the reasons why it's a bit heavier. But I think it's heavily justified, and honestly, I'm pretty strong, so I don't really care holding an extra bit of weight.
Mostly inside is haptic sensors.
Exactly. So anyway, we open this up, get the this sensing thingy thing, this box.
Very nice.
I'm thinking that this is the backside, so we should be able to open it up like this from the front. And here we have the controller itself. Now, this one came quite similar. Well, this one is coming quite similar to the one we got inside the box. Nothing different. It's the exact same controller. If you take a look at it and a bit closer, I would say that the triggers are much, much bigger now. They're lengthier, it's easier to control, it feels much better on the hand. The D-pad is quite similar to the PlayStation 4 controller. It's pretty much the same D-pad, except obviously it's bit more glossy white. It's a better texture, better make. And the microphone is right here. The mute button is right here. This button, it goes orange when you mute it, which I'll show you guys right here, which is the one that's on already. If I press this one, it goes orange to show that the microphone is muted. No, don't worry about that. This one is muted, so that's pretty cool. This is unmuted, muted. So you don't have to worry about having to have a headset on while speaking in game. If you're playing an online multiplayer, you can use the controller's microphone. Apparently it's pretty good, or good enough. so that people can hear you. But obviously, I recommend you to use headphones, preferably the ones that Sony give.
For PS5.
For the PS4. They don't give one for PS5, but they do give one for PS4, so I recommend you guys to do that. Anyway, other than that, I think this is a very, very straightforward controller, pretty much the same as the one that we got for the PS5. It is a standardized model as of 2020. Honestly, it's easier to find this, but it's harder to find the actual console, which is kind of a joke this time around. But that's pretty much how we got here today, guys. Now, I really hope you enjoy this video, because I honestly didn't really plan much for it. I didn't expect myself getting a PlayStation 5 today, but I did, and here I am. So as always, keep calm. Keep playing.